Hello, today we are taking a trip under the sea and we are going to be making artwork inspired by the ocean. So today we're going to be making a few ocean creatures. We are going to make some fish, we're going to make a jellyfish, we're also going to make a crab and some starfish, and then some stuff for the background like the coral and some rocks. All right, so let's get started. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to draw my ocean or sea floor, and that's the bottom of the ocean. So I'm going to draw a wavy line on the bottom, and that's going to be where the sand is on the bottom of the ocean. I'm going to do another one right here. So two wavy lines, one, two, and it's okay if it doesn't look exactly like mine. All right, above our sand, we're going to start our fish. And to make the fish, it's super easy. It's two curvy lines together. So to draw my first line, it's just going to be a arched shape like this, kind of like a smile, an upside down smile, so a frown, or an arch shape or a rainbow shape. The smile line is going to be underneath. So we have our frowny line, and now we have our smile, and they're going to touch just like that. And that's going to make the fish's body. The fish needs to be able to swim and steer itself around, so he needs that back tail. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a line sticking up from here. Same thing over here, another line going down the opposite way. It's going to make kind of like a triangle, just like that. And it's okay if it's kind of a wavy line. It doesn't have to be perfectly straight. To make his top fin, you're going to go up, just have a line going up like this, and then coming back down. And all fish have different, or all species of fish have different tails and fins and designs and colors. So if your fish does not look exactly like mine, it is okay. So I think I'm just gonna have a little piece go a little bit further over, just like that. And then he needs his front flippers or front fins. So I'm gonna draw a curvy line, another curvy line, and that's gonna make his front fin and side fin. Then he needs some lips, some fish lips. So I'm gonna draw an oval and then an oval really small to make the mouth. And then we're going to make a circle for the eye, just like that. And again, if your fish doesn't look exactly like mine, it is okay. And then our fish needs scales. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna draw a curvy line for his rest of his head. So just a curvy line going like this. And then for his scales, it's like a backwards letter C. Or like a U that's been turned on its side. And this is gonna give the texture of his scales. So that's our first fish. If I wanna make another friend for our fish, we'll do the same types of lines. So frown line, smile line going up, a line going down, and then a line connecting it to make the fin. And again, they can be wavy lines because they're floating around in the water and it's gonna be a little bit wavy. I'll do the same thing up top for the top fin, add my two little fins in the front, eyeballs, lips, curvy line for the back of the head, and then the scales. Okay, to make a jellyfish, what you're gonna do, it's the same types of lines. So it's going to be a frown line, so that rainbow or upside down smile. And then instead of making it curvy like our fish, like one big curvy line, we're gonna do some little curves. So it's gonna be a wavy line, and that's gonna be the bottom of I was gonna call him a starfish, our jellyfish. And then jellyfish have tentacles, so it's kind of like spaghetti or like hair sticking out. So it's just gonna be wavy lines like this sticking out from the bottom. That's all you have to do. And if you want some thicker lines, you can do that as well, but you can add as many or as little details as you want. So that's our jellyfish. And if you have a different way to draw your jellyfish, go for it. All right, now for the crab. We're gonna have a crab just kind of walking on the bottom here. So same shapes we've been using. So in between my two lines that I drew in the beginning for the sand, because crabs, they kind of like walk on the bottom, we're gonna draw that arch line again. And again, it's like an upside down smile, so a frown. And then we're gonna connect it for the bottom, just like that. That's gonna be for his shell. And then they have long legs. So what I'm gonna do is from the corners of my crab, I'm gonna draw some lines sticking out, kind of like a spider. Just like that. Kind of like a triangle. Up and then down, up, down, up, down, up, down. And the reason why the legs in the back are smaller is because they're further back. And then we can give our crab some claws. So we'll have two lines sticking up here, two lines sticking up on this side, kind of like antennas. And then a big circle for one claw, and then a big circle for the other claw. And then we can make a line in the middle for where the claws open and close. And you have a crab. And then I'll give him some eyes. And he can be a happy crab, he's smiling. All right. And then if you want to bubble in the legs, you can do that. So it looks like a spider to me, but that's okay. Okay, just go with it. And now for starfish. So to make the starfish, and these are kind of hard to draw, so it takes practice. So if you don't get it the first time, it's totally okay. But what you're going to do is you're going to draw a long, skinny oval pointing up, or up, I should say. And then you need two lines sticking out on both sides. And you're going to bubble that in. And then it's got two legs, and they're going to be like a V shape. So one line's going to stick out this way, and one line's going to stick out this way. And then we're going to bubble it in. And like I said, it takes practice. And even mine right here, I didn't make it perfect. I'm not gonna worry about it because it takes practice. So I'm gonna try to draw a smaller one next to it. And another one up here. But it takes practice, so see how you do. It's totally fine. And if you make a mistake, you can always erase it and try again. All right, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm gonna do some more fish in the background, a school of fish, like a group of fish that are swimming together. So it's same shapes as my first two fish, but they're gonna be further away, so they're gonna be look like they're smaller. So again, same lines. They're gonna be like ovals. Just draw a few. Okay, and then triangles for the back fin. And these triangles are like tipped over on their sides. So a line coming out this way, a line going up, so down, up, and then close it up. And then you can make the little tiny triangles on top for the top fin. And then I'll add some little lines for the bottom front fins. And I'm not even gonna give them eyes because they're so far away, but you can give them eyes. Now, if you wanted to add a shark, a dolphin, a mermaid, a sunken ship, a treasure chest, you could totally do that. I wanna keep it kind of simple. So what I'm just gonna add is some seaweed and some rocks and some coral. So for the seaweed, all you have to do is draw squiggly lines coming up from the ocean floor, and that's gonna make your seaweed. And then when we color it, we'll make it thicker. For the coral is kind of like shaped like a tree, our fingers sticking up. So when we learned about trees, how they have those branches, same thing with coral. So you're gonna have the base or the stump, I guess, of the coral, like a tree or the tree trunk. And then it's gonna have long lines coming out, like fingers. So it's gonna kind of look like little tiny colored trees. I'll do another little coral over here. So the trunk and then the fingers sticking out. And you can draw as much coral as you want. It's a perfect place for your fish to hide. What you can also do is draw some dots for the sand. It's gonna give the texture of that sand. And then some bubbles. We need some bubbles. So we'll have some bubbles coming out from our fish's mouths. Not too many. I think I'm just gonna leave it like that. All right, so I'm gonna color this in. Okay, so I colored in my fish, and to make the water, instead of coloring everything in for the water, I just drew some wavy lines, and that's gonna show the water moving around, and it's also gonna keep your picture light so you can see all the details that you added. Same thing with the ground, or the seafloor, I should say, or the ocean floor. So what you're gonna do is you're just gonna draw some lines, and that's gonna show the lines for the sand, but also not keep it too dark. And then I also added some rocks because that's a good place for the crab and other sea creatures to hide. And I think that's it. If you have any other ideas, you can add them to your picture. Like I said, it could be a mermaid, it could be a dolphin, it could be a shark. Whatever you want, you can add it to your picture. In fact, I had another one here. I had a few more details too. So you can customize or make your picture any way you want. Okay, so enjoy, have fun drawing and making that under the sea world. And I will see you guys next time.